Are we reading your thoughts? No. All we're doing is measuring the amount of blood flowing near the surface of your brain, and it relates to how hard you're working, how hard you're thinking, or how much you're holding in your memory. I want to know how busy you are. You might be doing way more than the next person, but I can't tell by the amount of work you're doing. I can tell by measuring your mental state. A computer is a very powerful information processing device. Human brain is also very powerful. The two are connected by this miserable low bandwidth connection of poking things with your finger, seeing pictures with your eye. User interfaces are complicated and clumsy. Our goal is to make them easier. Could we make the system adapt more to your particular mental state or to your needs and desires? It has to be very easy and passive. It shouldn't require any specific effort. And we need to do it in real time. And then the user interface could adapt your workload assignments to match. And our particular way is using near-infrared spectroscopy. We're collaborating with Professor Sergio Fantini in the biomedical engineering department at Tufts, who's a pioneer in that area. So it's a fortunate collaboration that we can work on a leading-edge measurement technology because we have the right guy just down the hall.
My research area is in using light to look inside the human body to get valuable information about our health and our state of mind. When our brain works, when our neurons are firing, are working, they require energy, and energy comes in the forms of oxygen and glucose, which is provided by the blood flow. Oxygenated blood is bright red, while deoxygenated blood is dark red, it's almost blue. So this kind of changing color is what we are sensitive to with the optical methods. With Professor Jacob, we have been constantly in contact between his group and my group on how to maximize the information content of the data that were collected.
The actual instrument we're using is a careful, expensive laboratory instrument, but all that's inside of it is a light measuring device. Someday that could be quite cheap and quite portable. The most straightforward application, it's not one we've actually done, but it's a good one for explanation, is think of air traffic controllers. You have several air traffic controllers in a busy airport. A new situation arises, and when I know which one can handle this job, I could give it to them. We have a couple of other experiments where we can measure preference. If you are drowning in information, could we use this to figure out what to emphasize or de-emphasize? We've also been able to measure interruption. The difference between an interruption that derails you versus an interruption where it's a mindless task, you can go right back to it without losing anything. You can envision this being used in a convenient device for regular people in regular situations someday. And it could make it easier to work with computers. Or conversely, could we make it so you can do much harder and more complicated things with the same amount of effort?